Assalomu alaykum, hurmatli talabalar. Siz bilan Mirzo Ulug'bek nomidagi O'zbekiston Milliy universiteti xorijiy filologiya fakulteti ingliz filologiyasi kafedrasi o'qituvchisi Kengboyeva Mavluda. Biz siz bilan bugungi darsimizda tabiiy ofatlar to'g'risida suhbatlashamiz. Keling, darsimizning keyingi qismini ingliz tilida davom ettiramiz. Marhamat. Dear students, before beginning the main part of our lesson, I want to take a look at 10 ways humans have left a footprint that has forever changed the environment and the planet. We as humans have become dependent on luxuries such as cars, houses, and even our cell phones. But what does our love for manufactured metallic and plastic goods do to the environment? Human activity can be directly attributed to the cause of hundreds of extinctions in the last two centuries versus the millions of years that extinctions naturally occur. As we progress through the 21st century, humans have changed the world in unprecedented ways. Human impact on the environment has become one of the main topics on the agenda. So, these 10 ways. The first one is overpopulation. Next, pollution. Global warming. Climate change. Genetic modification, ocean acidification, water pollution, deforestation, acid rain, and the last one is ozone depletion. And why I told about these things? I want you to think one more time about your behavior and about your attitude to the environment. Okay, guys, let's begin the main part of our lesson. What do you think, dear students? How many types of natural disasters are there? Look at this list. Today we will discuss some of them. The first one is, in our list, earthquake, tsunami, volcano eruption, tornadoes, avalanche, hurricane, forest fire, and flood. Guys, look at this picture and try to guess what kind of disaster is it. Of course, it is avalanche. An avalanche is like a mudslide, except it's made up of snow and ice. They occur in the mountains after fresh snow falls and can travel at 80 miles an hour or 128 kilometers per hour. Next one. What do you think? What is it? Of course, it's earthquake. Earthquake is caused by the movement of the Earth's plates, which lie under the surface of the Earth. Earthquakes occur suddenly. 4 out of 5 earthquakes take place in the Pacific Rim. The next picture. Look attentively. What is it? Of course, you are right. It is flood. Floods are one of the worst natural disasters and cost the most money. They occur when storms cause rivers to overflow or by high tides. They cause enormous damage and loss of life. And the next one is hurricane. You are right. Hurricanes are strong tropical storms with high winds and heavy rain that develop in the Atlantic Ocean. Each hurricane has a boy's or girl's name. They cause tremendous damage when they hit land. They occur from June until November in the US. What do you think, guys? What kind of disaster is it? You are right, it's tornado. A tornado is a spinning tube of air that touches the ground and a cloud above. They usually travel only a few miles but can destroy everything in their way. The US has 1,200 a year, more than anywhere else in the world. This one. Of course, tsunami. A tsunami is a train of gigantic waves that occur after an earthquake or volcanic eruption. They can be as high as 30 meters or 10 feet and travel as fast as a jet plane and go as far inland as 2 kilometers. Most tsunamis happen in the Pacific. The next disaster is, what do you think? Yes, volcano eruption. Volcanoes are explosions that happen from openings in the Earth's surface. Most volcanoes are located in the Pacific Rim. When volcanoes erupt, they spew magma, lava, and ash. There are between 1,300 and 1,500 volcanoes on Earth. Okay, try to guess the next word. What kind of disaster is it, guys? Yes, it is forest fire. Forest fires are fires that burn in forest area. Lightning can start them, but usually careless people do. There are 100,000 fires in the US every year. They can travel at 14 miles an hour or 23 kilometers per hour, and they will destroy everything as they move. Drought and hot weather also responsible for many forest fires. Dear students, this is the end of our today's lesson. Try to find more information about natural disasters and try to learn as much vocabulary as you can, because it can help expand your vocabulary baggage, improve your speaking skill and reading skill also. Have a good day. Bye-bye.